Walking around all day can zap your energy. What if we could harvest some of the excess energy from our walking and use it to keep the lights on?
Hi, I'm Matt Stillwell, Assistant Director of Education for the Wisconsin MRSEC. Scientists and engineers are working to develop technology that could make this dream a reality. And today I'll show you how to build a simple version of that technology using some inexpensive supplies that you might already have lying around the house. The technology I mentioned is called a Triboelectric Nanogenerator. I'll call them TANGs for short. Here's an example of what I'm going to show you how to build today.
And here's an example of one of them in action. Note that you'll have to look straight down at the LED to use it. Simply tap on the device and maybe move somewhere dark, since the lights won't be particularly bright.
Let's take a look at a schematic so we can see what's going on. The type of tang we're building today consists of two identical paper strips. Each paper strip has the end of a wire placed partway onto it, and the exposed metal of that wire is covered with some aluminum foil. The aluminum foil is then secured to the wire and paper with some transparent tape. These two paper aluminum foil tape strips are taped together at two opposite edges, and the wires connect to an LED bulb. Here's another look at this tang, where hopefully you can see a few of the things I was talking about a little better, like the stripped wire sandwiched between the aluminum foil and paper. If you look closely, you'll see that the aluminum foil piece is narrower than the paper and clear tape layers, which helps to keep the three layers stuck together. To understand how this device works, we'll need to talk about the effect for which these devices are named, the triboelectric effect, or triboelectricity. Triboelectricity is a form of static electricity that occurs when two dissimilar materials come into contact, like a balloon and your hair, and has to do with the atoms in the materials. Atoms are the building blocks of all materials and are made up of three particles, protons, neutrons, and electrons. These particles have a property called electric charge. Well, the neutron has no charge, but protons have a positive charge and electrons have a negative charge. When two dissimilar materials come into contact, like this balloon and piece of fur, there is an exchange of electrons where one material takes some electrons from the other material. When the materials separate, one of them now has more positive charge and the other has more negative charge. If you've ever walked across carpet while wearing socks and then shocked yourself on a doorknob, you've encountered one of the ways those charges can rebalance themselves. Triboelectric nanogenerators take advantage of this same principle as you shocking yourself on that doorknob. Except instead of shocking yourself, they send the electricity through a circuit. Each time we tap this nanogenerator, we're forcing the paper from one strip and the tape covering the other paper strip into contact. When this happens, the tape takes some electrons from the paper in the process. When the two strips separate, electrons flow from one side to the other to try and balance out the charges in each strip and achieve electrical equilibrium. When we bring the strips back together, the electrons flow in the other direction to achieve electrical equilibrium again. The LEDs we'll be using are a type of diode, which means that they only let electricity flow in one direction. So depending on which way you connect your LED, you'll either see a flash of light when you bring the strips together or when you let them go apart. Try it out once you're done building. Let's go over the supplies we'll need to build a nanogenerator before we get into the actual building itself. For each nanogenerator you want to build, you'll need two wires, which you can use either something like these jumper wires that I have here, or you might be able to take a twist tie from like a sandwich bag and cut off the plastic to expose the metal there. You'll need an LED, which you might be able to use something from an old keychain flashlight that you don't want anymore, or something else that you can find around the house. a piece of paper, like an index card or something else that has a nice, a little bit more sturdy. And then we're gonna need some aluminum foil. Any kitchen aluminum foil should do fine. You'll need some clear, transparent office tape and a pair of scissors to help us cut some of these things up. To build our nanogenerators, we're gonna first get some exposed metal from our wires. If you're using jumper wires, some of them will just pull right off and you can get a little bit of exposed metal there. You might need to do some trimming on your own, either with scissors or preferably wire cutters if you have them. If you're using scissors, be really careful. You just barely need to touch this plastic to get through it enough to be able to pull it off with your fingernails. So I've got one wire now with an exposed end. Here I have another one, so these are going to be good to go. And we're going to cut two strips. And I recommend, to make it easy on you, cut your strip of paper about as wide as the tape that you're working with. So go ahead, get a measurement on that, see how wide your strip is and your tape, and cut the strip according to that. Doesn't need to be exact, just want it to be close enough. We'll make two strips, same size. We want our aluminum foil to be a little bit more narrow than the paper itself. Now what we'll do, we're going to do this same thing for both strips of paper, where we're going to place the wire on them, put the aluminum foil on top of the wire, and then we're going to put a layer of tape down to secure these two edges of the paper. Should be able to see there's a little bit of paper on either side of the aluminum foil. That's what we're going to stick the tape to. Whoa, and it looks like my wire came out, so I can just stick that in again, try and sandwich it closed, and if you need to, you can use a little bit of tape to try and grab onto the wire as well. So it should look a little something like this. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Now that we have our two strips, we're going to lay them right on top of each other. And I think it's easiest to have the wires on the same side. And we're going to need these to be able to separate, so you might sort of make opposite creases in them. So one bends one way and one wants to bend the other. And we're just going to connect these with a thin section of tape. And we'll want to make sure that these two pieces kind of naturally separate, so when we're not pushing on them, they'll push apart. And the last thing we'll do is we'll take our LED and these two metal legs that are here. We're going to put one of those into each of these little black ports. Your Triboelectric Nanogenerator is ready for use. Now, these homemade nanogenerators don't produce much electricity, so your light might be dim. I recommend finding a dark place to test it. Scientists and engineers are using more sophisticated versions of this type of nanogenerator for a variety of applications, like this piece of flooring developed at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Just like we created a little electricity from our tapping, the nanogenerators embedded in the flooring create electricity when people walk on them. Just think of all the wasted energy when a lot of people walk around at an airport or a shopping center. How might you use a technology like this to capture some of that energy? How might you adapt the design of the device to capture even more energy? Let me know what you're thinking in the comments below.